Hey guys, it's me, Cubix. It's almost 2015, so what better way to end the year than to go back to 2010 and review the Dian Guhong version 1. For newer cubers who are unfamiliar with the Dian Guhong, this cube is easily one of the most influential speed cubes ever created. It was able to instantly lower times for cubers, and it paved the road for nearly all of the speed cubes you use today. On a more personal note, the Guhong was sort of the first mainstream speed cube I ever owned. I owned a Dian Sheng and an old Maru speed cube before, but the Guhong really galvanized my interest in speed cubing. The Dian Guhong is a 57mm puzzle with standard stickers. These stickers are a lot duller than the Moyu shades, but they're still high quality and they look okay on white plastic. People are blown away by the performance of Moyu cubes, but the Guhong is still really competitive. I like tighter cubes, and even on my tensions, the corner cutting is over 45 degrees. The Guhong is still one of the best cubes for reverse corner cutting as well, at about 3/4 of the piece. Unfortunately, the feel of the cube is kind of a mixed bag. Older Guhongs had different plastic, which made the cube feel gummy, while newer batches feel slicker and crisper. The gummy feeling would be slow by today's standards, but back then, we were all just excited that the cube could reverse corner cut. The Guhong was really the first cube that could corner cut to such extremes. With previous mechanisms, such as with Type A's, cubes could only corner cut a single QB, and certain mods allowed for the smallest amounts of reverse corner cutting. A lot of people don't know this, but even though the Guhong was able to break both barriers, the mechanism itself was already done before. It might be hard to believe, but the Guhong's mechanism is identical to that of a bandaged V-Cube 6. V-Cubes had a legal tussle with Dian over patent infringement, but never brought this up. Had V-Cubes noticed this particular similarity, they would have had a much stronger case. The one downfall of the Guhong by today's standards is popping. Due to the lack of any torpedoes, the cube can pop at larger corner cuts. However, people were able to use screws to act like torpedoes, and this actually solved the popping issue completely. Years later, Dian also released the Guhong V2, which included the same torpedoes as the Zanchi. Overall, even today, I would still recommend the Dian Guhong. It may no longer be the best speed cube, but it did spawn the creation of nearly all current speed cubes you see today. When I started making cube reviews, my final grades for 3x3s were actually based on the Guhong. For that reason, by default, the Dian Guhong receives a B. You may have noticed that a common grade I give cubes is a B+. That's because although cubes have gotten better, they haven't made huge impacts or improvements like the Guhong did in its time. The improvements since this cube came out have been marginal, and realistically, cubes that have received A's from me haven't been all that better than this cube from 2010. The Dian Guhong is by far one of my favorite cubes, and I think it's worth getting, even if only for collection purposes. If you would like to buy the Guhong, the links are in the description. Thank you to Cuboos for suggesting this video. Please tell me which videos you'd like to see in the comments below. Thank you all for watching, and until next time, toodles.